A very good evening. You're watching News 9 with me, Akshita. Well, no matter what the incident is, everybody remains to know the real story. Today, we will show you the original scene of the incident where the students from Hyderabad were drowned in Himachal Pradesh.
This is how it happened. Four helpless students washed away. It all happened in less than 5 minutes. The students did not have time to figure out what was happening. Escaping not an option. The current gradually increases, but in less than 2 minutes' time, the water starts gushing with such force that the students are forced to hold on to each other, perched atop a small boulder right in the center of the river. First, two get washed away. And then all of them disappear. Localites can be seen running to save the students, but alas, they are already gone. Happy moments. Turn tragic. Video put to rest all speculation that the students whose bodies have not been recovered are still missing. It is clearly seen that the current washed them away in no time and probably claimed all their lives. Even as search operations enter the third day today, only 7 bodies have been found so far. Telangana Home Minister Narasimha Reddy visited the search operation spot today. The parents and family members of the missing students were also present at the spot, with tears rolling down their cheeks, waiting for the bodies to be recovered. Meanwhile, an FIR has been lodged against the dam project officials under Section 304A and Section 336 of the Indian Penal Code. Since it is now clearly evident that no alarm was sounded before the floodgates were opened, it now remains to be seen what measures the Himachal Pradesh government will take to ensure that justice is delivered to the bereaved families. A News 9 report.
And moving on, in what can be termed as an unprecedented move, Pakistan Prime Minister has written a letter to Narendra Modi. And here's what he's written.
putting to rest all speculations that he was unhappy with his visit to India, Nawaz Sharif, in his letter to Prime Minister Modi, has said that he was satisfied with the meaningful exchange of thoughts during the meeting held on May 27th. All eyes were on Pakistani Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif when he visited India to attend the swearing-in ceremony of Narendra Modi. Both the PMs met each other and exchanged pleasantries. Nawaz unhappy with the visit, says Pak media. However, the Pakistani media claimed that Nawaz Sharif was not too happy with the way India had handled his visit. It is reportedly said that Sharif felt disappointed when there was no joint press conference after the one-on-one meeting. But the letter has put an end to all speculations. Sharif further wrote on the matters that required immediate attention of both the prime ministers, stating that the countries are working towards a common economic destiny. The Pakistani prime minister stated that he would work on all unsettled matters for the benefit of both the nations. The letter by Nawaz Sharif is being seen as a positive development in Indo-Pak ties. The letter comes a fortnight after the Pakistani Prime Minister gifted a sari to Modi's mother, Hiraba. Looks like both the Prime Ministers are serious about improving ties between the two countries. A News 9 report.
Well, Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the Parliament for the first time today, and here are a few snippets from his speech.
Modi's first reply to President's speech. Narendra Modi reiterated what the President said 2 days back about his government's agenda. In a nutshell, Modi spoke about reviving brand India to its lost glory. This being his first speech in front of veteran parliamentarians, he began by seeking forgiveness if he made any mistakes. And as the President reiterated the roadmap for his government, Modi indeed seemed all confident to fulfill all the promises made by him.
मुझ जैसा एक नया व्यक्ति जब कुछ कह रहा है सदन की गरिमा और मर्यादाओं में कोई चूक हो जाए तो नया होने के नाते आप मुझे क्षमा करेंगे ऐसा मुझे पूरा विश्वास है लेकिन मैं इस सदन को विश्वास दिलाता हूं कि राष्ट्रपति जी ने जो रास्ता प्रस्तुत किया है उसको पूरा करने में हम कोई कोताही नहीं बरतेंगे हमारे लिए राष्ट्रपति जी का अभिभाषण ये सिर्फ परंपरा और रिचुअल नहीं
है नॉट जस्ट दैट ही वेंट ऑन टू ऐड दैट पीपल डाउटेड हिम व्हेन ही प्रॉमिस्ड टू प्रोवाइड 24 आवर्स इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लाई टू गुजरात ही डिलीवर्ड ऑन हिज प्रॉमिस डिस्पाइट ऑल द अप्रिहेंशंस In his hour-long speech, he touched upon every aspect that India is plagued by. Some of the key points that he reiterated were Government of the poor. Working for the poor is the topmost priority of the government. Using education as a weapon to fight poverty featured as the most important point in Modi's agenda.
Sarkar garibon ke liye honi chahiye. सरकार का सबसे पहला दायित्व होता है कि वे गरीबों की सुने और गरीबों के लिए जिए
हैव टू एंश्योर वुमेन सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी विद न्यूमरस इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ क्राइम अगेंस्ट वुमेन कमिंग टू लाइट आफ्टर मोदी सरकार टुक चार्ज हिज की कंसर्न नाउ इज टू मेक द कंट्री सेफ फॉर वुमेन Northeastern states not left out. The leaders of the northeastern states have time and again expressed their anger for being ignored by the center, even in times of distress. But Modi made sure that he doesn't make them feel the same. To glorify the northeastern states, he said that these states can be developed into organic states and ensure optimum usage of their potential. Modernize the agro sector. President reiterated that his government will reverse the trend of farmer suicides by ensuring more and more investments coming in both public and private sectors. Now Modi has gone on to add that improvement in technology and investing in improving the infrastructure and modernizing the sector will augur well for farmers and industry as a whole. Time for India to stand tall.
कि विश्व को डंके की चोट पर हम ये समझाएं कि कितनी बड़ी ताकत है हमारी.
In all, he highlighted the key points in the president's speech and reiterated the roadmap for the government. He not only congratulated the people of India for having voted for good governance, he ensured to emphasize that he will provide stability and set an example to the world. Gandhi and his values remembered. Taking cue from Mahatma Gandhi, who converted his movement into a revolution, he said that development and progress should be a mass movement and not the sole responsibility of the government. Reiterating what he said at Varanasi in his victory speech, cleanliness was a key concern for Mahatma Gandhi, and added that if every citizen develops a feeling within them that they are serving the country by not throwing trash on the road, their job is half done. So in his hour-long speech, he covered almost everything that the President of India had put forward. Changes are surfacing in the functioning of the government, but will it augur well for the country is what remains to be seen. A News 9 report.
Social activist S.R. Hiremath has reacted to the protest that took place in Kalasa in Chikmagalur yesterday. The whistleblower stated that he has not violated any law and that the protests were purely politically motivated. Speaking to media persons in Hubli, Hiremath added that he would never go against the poor and that allegations that are being levelled against him are all baseless. In fact, yesterday residents of Kalasa had staged a massive protest against S.R. Hiremath. They had claimed that they had lost all their land after Hiremath had claimed that the land was illegally encroached. One man had even attempted to set himself ablaze during the protest. S.R. Hiremath, however, cleared the air today, making it very clear that he does not hurt the poor. Let's listen to exactly what he had to say.
ನಾನು ಮೊದಲು ಹೋದಾಗನೇ ಇದು ಆವಾಜ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು. ನಾ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟೆ, ಪತ್ರಕರ್ತರು ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ನಾ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ನಾನು 30 ವರ್ಷಗಳಿಗಿಂತಲೂ ಹಿಂದೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಬಡವರಿಂದ, ಬಡವರ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲ. ನಮ್ಮ ಪೆಟಿಷನ್ನ ಏನೊಂದು 1000 ಪುಟದ್ದಿದೆ, ಅದರದೊಂದು ಪೂರ್ಣ ಕಾಪಿಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ಲೋಕಲ್ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟವಾಗಿ ನಾವು 10 ಎಕರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದವ್ರನ್ನ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ, ನಾವು ಚಿಕ್ಕವ್ರನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ.
S.R. Hiremath clearing the air there, clarifying that all of this is being simply politically motivated. But to once again highlight exactly what the issue was, well, the people came together in Kalasa in Chikmagalur just yesterday, staging a huge protest demanding action against S.R. Hiremath. They claimed that he made allegations that the land there was illegally encroached, leaving hundreds of people residing there homeless.